scroll.
Oh man, that joint still takes. Man, I love that song. That was Kim, I Can't Stop Loving You. And before that, I had Guapalé. Is that how you pronounce it?
Guapalé.
Guapalé with Closer. And I started that segment out with Mo Thugs featuring Crazy Bone with All Good. Renee, I know you got upset the other day when we was watching the news. And here in Atlanta, they was passing out vouchers for Section 8 housing. And you got upset about it. You want to explain?
Yeah, I got upset. It darn near brought me to tears. It really did. To see so many of our people.
Not just our people. Oh, you mean people, humans.
Yeah, black, Asian, white, other, that are in such dire need for that type of assistance and will basically go to mob behavior as far as crowd to get an application. That doesn't mean if you got an application, you're approved. It was just 30,000 people in the hot sun, in crowds, ununiformed, no unity, uniformity, nothing as far as the process of how they was going to hand out, no lines. It was just chaos. And I think the city of Atlanta should be embarrassed, as well as the federal government persons that set up the program to be distributed that way should be embarrassed. County commissioners, senators, congressmen, people in these y'all counties, y'all need to call them and hold them accountable for that type of actions and behavior, to have their constituents basically out there begging and groveling for Section 8. I mean, that makes no sense. I'm not all for Section 8 for a lot of people. Those people that were out there fighting and bum rushing, if you're able to fight, you're able-bodied, you should be able to do some kind of job. I don't want to hear that there's no jobs out there. There's something out there that you can do other than making babies and committing crime. Not that everybody that was trying to get Section 8 does that, but it was too many 20-year-old women, 18-year-old women that I saw out there with 6 and 7 different kids, tattoos all on their face and neck, standing there dressed to the nines with Gucci bags, whether real or not, talking about they better get their Section 8. I mean, no. Mm-mm. No. That's where I think the government should definitely stop the buck right there from this cyclical poverty.
Well, you know, they had 30,000 people show up, but they hadn't opened it up like that since 2000, I think they said 2002 or 2004, and they only had 2,500, I believe, that showed up back in that year, 2004.
And I think they should really need to revise the way they do that program. They really, really do. They need to either go to social services and get the names of women who are been on welfare, have completed college programs or some type of training programs, have tried to get work or have work, just can't pay for daycare. I think they should select candidates that way. And definitely the elderly people, the disabled, those that are sick, that cannot physically work. Like, there was one woman there with cancer. She shouldn't have had to be down there waiting in line. She's standing there with throat cancer, talking through a pipe in 90 degree weather at night. That doesn't make any sense. She shouldn't have had to be down there.
Well, yeah, I understand what you're saying. And I feel you. You feel me?
So the government needs to revamp the program. It needs not to be cut out totally, but to revamp how it makes its selection for those who get Section 8 and put a limit, a cap on certain participants who get Section 8. If you're old, disabled, and elderly, then you should get it till the end of life. Okay. If you're between the age of 18 and 55, then you should be up for reassessment every 12 to 18 months on whether you can need to continue to have Section 8. It should be a limit. Not that, okay, once you get it, you get to carry it on for the rest of your life as long as you have good behavior, then live wherever, wreaking havoc and still having multiple babies and only got to pay $25 a month to live in a house like where we live at, where you would normally have to pay maybe $2,200 a month for a mortgage.
We're not paying no $2,200. And I got to cut you off right there, Renee, because you were going on for hours and hours because you're so upset. Well, anyway, I got to get back into the show. And like I said, if you're just joining in, it's Flashback Fridays. And here's that Ashanti featuring Ja Rule with Happy. Keep it locked.